Hachette Audio presents Duet, written by Elise Broach, read by Carolyn Hewitt. In memory of my dear friend, the poet Anne Victoria Christie, lover of birds and words. 1. Music lesson. Call me Mirabelle. It's a nice name, don't you think? We all have pretty names, my mother says, because we're all beautiful. Every last one of us. There's no such thing as an ugly goldfinch. We're little and yellow, with gray, black, and white markings. But it's mostly the yellow you notice, like a beam of sunshine, or a marigold, or a lemon. Just seeing me, even for a split second, half hidden by leaves, a glimpse of that bright, flashing yellow, well, I promise you it is guaranteed to make you smile. Okay, I admit my brothers are an even brighter color than I am. The boys always are. Why is that? So annoying. They brag about it, too. But Mother says we girls have subtlety in our yellow hues. I like the sound of that. A subtle yellow is more elegant, I'm pretty sure. And I'm still yellow enough to brighten the grayest day. Early in the spring, when the old man, Mr. Starek, was sick, I sat on a branch outside his bedroom window to cheer him up. It had been a sad winter for him. His sister died, and even though she lived close by, they hadn't seen each other in years and years. Isn't that strange? I can't imagine not seeing my brothers for years, although they do make me mad sometimes. We all knew Mr. Starek was very upset. In a way, that surprised me. If he hadn't seen his sister in such a long time, why would he miss her now that she was gone? But he did miss her. He has no other family, from what we can tell. Maybe relatives far away in Europe, but not here in America. There's a photograph of his sister in his bedroom, and after she died, he would look at it sorrowfully for long periods. And then there was some trouble with her house. I'm not sure what exactly. Something involving money, and birds have no interest in money, so we didn't pay much attention. But the old man got sick in the middle of all this, and Mother told me to visit him. It seemed like the least I could do, since he always fills the bird feeder for us. Sometimes I would sing for him. The high limb of a dogwood tree grazes his window, so I would hop to the end of it, close to the pane, and let the song pour out of me, like water rippling or wind blowing through tall grass, something so free and fast and flowing that it can't be stopped. The old man would startle in his bed and turn toward the window, and then he'd listen intently. I could see the concentration in his face. I don't think I'm flattering myself when I say he looked impressed, like hearing me sing was a real tweet. Ha ha, treat, I mean. Bird joke. For a singer, there is no greater compliment than someone who truly listens to you. I'm a musical artist, you see. I prefer artiste, actually. It sounds more distinguished. All of us goldfinches can sing, of course, but I'm not like the rest of them, with their wild racket of chirping. I still have a lot of practicing to do, but I promise you this. When I sing, anyone within earshot knows it's a song. Which is why I like the old man. Mr. Starek appreciates music. He's a music teacher, a pianist, and from what I can tell, he used to be famous. He played the piano all over the world. Can you imagine? Packed on the shelves of his music room are shiny trophies and serious-looking plaques with his name on them. And hanging on the walls are framed pictures of the world's great composers. How do I know they're the world's great composers? Well, he plays their music on his piano, and I have ears, don't I? And something more important, which you can't really teach. Taste. Musical taste. I grew up listening to the old man play Beethoven, and Mozart, and Brahms, and Bach, and hearing him talk about music, week after week, to the piano students who came through his front door. Now, since he got sick, he's pretty much stopped teaching. Parents come begging for lessons, and he tells them he's retired. But I learned a lot while he was still giving piano lessons. He'd say things like,
"This is Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata. Movement one starts gently, softly like a lullaby."
Or,
"You need speed and delicacy for Debussy. When you touch the keys, imagine they are covered in flecks of gold. Pick up the flecks as quickly as possible."
See what I mean? For him, even talking about music is an art. It doesn't hurt that he has an accent. Mother says he's from Europe, a place called Poland, and he has a careful way of speaking that makes everything he says sound smart. I wish I had an accent, I tell Mother. You do have an accent, she says. You just can't hear it. If you flew all the way to Europe, you'd sound different to the birds over there. Isn't that funny? We all have accents. We just don't know it until we go someplace where people don't talk the same way we do. The children used to come to the old man's house almost every afternoon. Most of them lived in Boston, which is a big red and gray city about an hour from here, flying time. Remember, we birds don't have to follow roads or stop for traffic lights, so we can get to places a lot faster than you humans can. Anyway, the children's parents would bring them all the way out to Mr. Starek's little town for their lessons. A sweet-smelling silk tree grows near the music room, and I would perch on the bottom limb and watch the lessons through the window. I could see everything from there. I would sit perfectly still and listen, because listening is the best kind of learning for me. And birds have excellent hearing. Did you know that? Of the five senses, it's our second best after sight. I can hear the piano perfectly, even with the windows closed. And when I'm swept up in it, the music fills me almost the way it does when I'm singing. It swirls around me, sliding through my feathers like water, wave after wave washing into my soul. Oh, you didn't think birds had souls? Of course we do. With the music lessons, the children did get better over time, but they were never as good as the old man. I think we artists are the only ones who really know what it takes, and we recognize it in each other. Even now, when Mr. Starek goes into the music room and sits at the piano, his fingers dance over the keys, quickly, softly, and then with force. Ba-ta-ta-dum! I see his body sway, and his arms tense and then loosen as his long fingers span the keys. I feel the music beat in me like a second heart. Oh my goodness, does it make me want to sing? Sometimes the old man glances up and sees me. I think he can tell how excited I am. I miss the piano lessons he used to give. Honestly, I learned so much from them. The old man would often play a short piece for the child at the beginning of the lesson, and I loved listening to him. Sometimes, even now after he plays for a bit, he'll walk to the window to speak to me.
"Hello, little bird. Are you hungry?" he'll say. I field the bird feeder for you.
I pretend to be shy. If he comes too close, I hop backward on the branch and then fly away home to the shiny green holly tree. It grows by the fence in his backyard, and it's where.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.